to me is right here where you're shooting. This is my freedom. You know, I go to work a lot of hours a week. Home is here. This is my family, man. All this stuff makes me really happy, and everybody likes doing it. It brings together family, it brings together friends, brings together just great results and lots of people giving it their all. You know, home is right here where everybody comes together. Okay.
So what's your story?
What's my story? That's hard to... You gotta make that a little easier for me.
I grew up around racing. You know, that's pretty much how I grew up. My dad and mom raced, you know. And so I guess, you know, in the bloodline, it's there. Why I do it, I question sometimes because of the intensity and the labor hours and everything. Racing is, you know, it's something that makes me get up every morning. You know, it's the older I get, the less I, you know, I'm still as intense as ever, but I may be a little bit more relaxed about the adrenaline rush. I don't get nervous anymore. I haven't gotten nervous for a race in 15 years. You know, it's just what I love to do.
I was fortunate enough to win Rookie of the Year, win the Virginia Canyon Hill Climb my rookie year, and the rest is pretty much history with the 18 wins I've got in one exhibition and 21 points championships for the Colorado Hill Climb Association. And like I said, the 18 titles on Pikes Peak, several records still stand that I said, and that's pretty much my story. Wouldn't be that current on it, but I was just inducted into the Colorado Motorsports Hall of Fame and they want a resume, so I've been looking all this stuff up. Because I really didn't remember it all very good. Because I've always felt that if you talk about yourself, it's not cool. You let your right foot do your talking and the other people talk for you if you get the job done. If you don't, then you shouldn't talk anyway.
Racing just brings out a different side in everybody, or me at least. I see it in my dad, I see it in my grandpa.
I'm Leonard Vahsholtz, and I own Vahsholtz Automotive and Racing along with wife Barb. And I'm an engine builder and mechanic, and used to be a race car driver, but now I just kind of mess around, do a little stick shifter, drag racing is all. In my particular case, that's how you support your race car. I can work 40 hours a week and pay the bills, but if I work 80 hours a week, I can run a good race car.
I'm gonna race the race, you know, I'm gonna race to win. And if, you know, if I lost some ability, or I felt that I just didn't have that instinct anymore, then that would definitely, you know, I'd rather go boating than race for fifth place, you know.
And to me, Pikes Peak is pretty well known, but I think you can win in certain classes without having to be a professional you know, IndyCar driver or something. And so I think we've proven that between Clint's 21 wins and my 18 and Cody's one, we have 40 wins total. So that's doing pretty good for a hometown boy.
The mountain, you know, it's just a risk in its own. You know, even just driving a normal daily car up there, you know, you lose your brakes and just a riskful event, you know. Risky event.
I was still shaking, man.
I'm Cody Vahsholtz, live in Woodland Park, Colorado, 24 years old. I'm a racer. I like riding motorcycles and racing cars and anything that goes fast, I guess.
I like the idea that, you know, some of the divisions are becoming more factory likable, to where, you know, that you can run a factory Porsche or Ford or whatever and be identified as that brand, because you know, the Time Attack 1 and 2 division kind of scale that, electric division to a degree scales that. So I like that entity. Because like the car you see behind me right now, it's not identifiable as a Ford in any stretch of imagination. But it's you know, it's sixth fastest car in Pikes Peak for being handmade, hand built. So pretty impressive. The cool thing about motorcycle racers is they're most of them are really open to talk to you and, you know, just conversate and joke around with each other and just have fun. You know, they're not super strained or whatever you want to call it. They're just outgoing, really, really fun to hang out with. They're good people.
Copy. Do what you gotta do. Where are you gonna do that at, Crystal?
we're stopping them right here at the start line now, and they've got the gateway closed. The only problem we're having right now is at the gateway we're turning traffic around because this is going to be a lengthy process.
Hot Carl, as I knew him, was a good friend of mine, and he was my road race instructor, and he sorted me out on that thing. And I just can't believe that we lost him up here, and I just can't believe that he was one of the persons that, you know, sacrificed everything up here doing something he loved. And it was an amazing morning I was sharing with him. He was smiling so big and having such a good time. And without that kind of charisma, I would have never gone as far as I have. And surrounded myself with him and the great people he surrounds himself with, that we are all here surrounded with now, make up just the great thing that this race is.
Just like to show our support and love, you know, for the sport. And it's a bad deal that it happened that way, but you know, the way I look at it is he was doing what he loved. And then for them to get the bike put back together and ride it up to the summit, I thought that was really cool. I think he would like that, you know. And I'm sure he was watching down on it and respected it a lot. Don't wish it on anybody. Never wish it happens, but that's part of the risk you take. And I guess it was just his time. But they shifted your scene in all of your dreams and everything in your heart. If they lifted you up and pulled you down, saying things to sound, but it's your side. So baby, dry your eyes, and it's your time. It's your time to
I like the touchy feel. I'd like to know what the car is under me, how it's set up and everything. That's, I think, what's allowed me to have a, you know, fairly good winning record, is because I am a two-part, you know, I'm a driver and a crew.
It just comes pretty easy to me, you know. I feel really natural at it.
It's just natural. You know, he's got the correct body size and dynamics and ergonomics to, you know, be a great motorcycle rider, and he's proven that he is.
I guess I do it for the fun and then the self-gratification, you know, you get out of it. The accomplishment whenever you finish or maybe not finish, but know that you were prepared and you just had a mishap or something like that. It just keeps you hungry all the time, you know, keeps you busy.
So are you the Cody? You are the Cody. No way! Oh my god, dude! I'm so happy to meet you! Oh shit! Can you sign me one of those?
I guess I could.
Yeah! Oh! Oh, nice airtime.
Making sure my motor's good, going through, you know, checking all the vital components, wheel bearings, chains, sprocket wear. Getting sleep, eating right, staying hydrated, trying to line up sponsorship and things like that.
Fuck done, exhaust system.
Just making sure everything's ready.
I think Cody's got the best chance to win. I think Clint is because he's a front engine modified in an open wheel IndyCar type division, we have a very inferior car.
It's, you know, 700 pounds fat compared to the competition, and it's a front engine car versus a rear engine.
I think that Clint's the master of getting everything out of his car and putting the three segments together on race day and not making a mistake.
You know, just try and fight for a little bit of speed, but yet have good downforce. And
I think if he does that, he can probably go 10 seconds faster than he did last year, which was a record time of, what, 9:54? I'm not so sure that the Dahlenbeck car can't go in the 9:30s because it's a pretty trick race car, and they're doing a good job with it.
Everybody, good luck, stay safe, have a good run, and make it to the summit, and we can all enjoy the beautiful day we have here on the mountain.
Race day is just a different gig, you know, because you get one run at it and you get one chance, and it's the middle of the day, so everything's different than what you practice. You know, I had a really good race day car. I had a little hiccup in the pit, well, on pit road, you know, with being rushed a little bit. We just didn't quite have our time frame figured out. So that, you know, broke me up a little bit. Really maybe left about 3 or 4 seconds on the table, but I think that's about as good as that car can do.
Thank you.
It was weird, different. It seems like every year you get to the summit, you know, the weather forecast says it's supposed to be nice all day. Ends up snowing or raining or really windy or something. Got up to the top and it was really nice. You know, you'd sit out there with shorts and get a suntan, you know, pretty much sitting on the sun. And then all of a sudden within 10 minutes it got cloudy and started thundering, lightning everywhere. Snowed about an inch. They had to shorten the race up. So it was a little different. You know, I've obviously had bad weather up there, but never anything like that. It was a different experience. Necessarily know if I want her to go as fast as I do, but I do want her to ride and race, you know, because I just think it gives you so much opportunity in life. You meet so many people in this racing world.
Never pushed Cody into it. My dad didn't push me into it, but that was all I knew, and you know, he gave me good opportunities. And
I think if there was anything I was gonna do over, probably be, I'd start racing earlier in my life instead of waiting like I did, get into it sooner. That's probably the only thing I'd change.
And as far as Willow goes, I mean, we'll just have to wait and see, you know. But if there was no racing anymore because we didn't want to, then hey, that's what it is. We got all that stuff to look back on.
We know we're going fast, and I guess it all kind of just came together this year. You know, everything clicked, and we all had fun. Our bike was working good. I was in tune with my bike and myself, and it just showed good results.
And as far as next year goes, you know, I highly doubt I'll run this same car. You know, I'd like to, you know, either build something that's, you know, in the mid to low nines would be, you know, that might even be a retirement deal for me if I got that low. I don't see me in the eights. You know, there's just not enough funding. And if it, you know, if I ever got a chance to run a sub nine car, I'd definitely hop in it in a heartbeat and take advantage of that situation.
There's a lot of stuff up in the air right now. And there's a 364 days, so we'll see. Time will tell on that one.
Nice burnout.
You like that?
Yeah.
I mean, smiling at that.
Yeah.
You got the guys. Drill the hill.
That's all.
Dude, you got it, Daddy. Nice burnout, too. We were watching all the way down.
Hey, buddy. That was a good job. Good Daddy did a great job.
Good game.
Oh, I know.
I did.
Oh, look at that.